And so here we are in the shadows of Liberty's flame. From the harbor to the home of the Heisman here at the Downtown Athletic Club, built in 1930 on the very site where President George Washington took leave of the last Congress to have met in New York. Hello and good evening, everyone. I'm Jim Nantz. In the next 30 minutes, a bit more Heisman history will be made. The Downtown Athletic Club is a landmark in Lower Manhattan, but for the last half century, what has really made this 3,100-member club world famous is visible the minute you enter the lobby. It's the Heisman Memorial Trophy, and it bears the name of all 50 recipients, dating back to 1935, when the award, then simply called the Downtown Athletic Club Trophy, was presented to the University of Chicago's great triple threat, Jay Berwanger. Tonight, another name will be added to the original trophy, and that announcement will take place 13 floors above us, where Pat Hayden is now standing by.
All right, thank you very much, Jim. After four distinguished decades of coaching, John Heisman was named the first athletic director of the Downtown Athletic Club. And appropriately, we are here in the Heisman Room. The room is now filled with club members, former winners like John Cappelletti, who won the award in 1973, and even Frank Gillescu, the sculptor who created the trophy. And here in the front row, four of this year's most outstanding college football players. First, Gordy Lockbaum of Holy Cross. Brian Bosworth of Oklahoma. Paul Palmer of Temple. And Miami's Vinny Testaverde, the heavy favorite to win this year's Heisman Trophy.
This CBS Sports Special, the Heisman Trophy Award, is sponsored by Eastman Kodak Company, creators of Kodacolor VRG film, the color of life, of Kodak VR 35 cameras, the easy way to shoot great 35mm pictures, and makers of new Kodak Super Life batteries. Don't settle for less. Go for the gold.
Club where tonight they're going to announce the 51st winner of the Heisman Trophy. Here in the Heisman Room, the walls are adorned with the portraits of the 50 previous winners. Of course, Archie Griffin of Ohio State won the award twice, but it has become apparent that these men share more than excellence on the football field, for they have proven in almost every case to be winners in a much larger sense of the word.
It's a symbol of competitiveness. It's a symbol of achievement. A symbol of excellence.
It represents excellence, you know, excellence in athletic ability and having an excellent football team.
Well, the Heisman Trophy is definitely a great award, and I would say to any athlete that wins it, that it's no other great award to win in the country.
The Heisman Trophy, the symbol of college football success. But for Pete Dawkins, Archie Griffin, and Billy Sims, it represents much more than gridiron glory. 1958 was a magical year for Pete Dawkins. He led Army to an undefeated season, a number three ranking, and of course, the Heisman Trophy. There was no pro football career for Dawkins. Following a Rhodes scholarship, he began a highly successful military and government service career. Now he has carved a new niche for himself on Wall Street. Regardless of the challenge, the Heisman set the standard.
People have seen you as a symbol of accomplishment, achievement, and excellence. Having been granted the mantle of being a Heisman winner does oblige you to set your sights very high.
Archie Griffin ascended to unparalleled heights, winning two Heismans. He went on to play with the NFL Bengals, but never achieved the same exalted status. In 1983, Griffin went bankrupt, but the qualities that led him to two Heismans helped him rebound.
In football, you know, there is one thing you learn. If you learn nothing else, you learn how to get back up after being knocked down. And you learn from football and get back up and continue to strive for the goals that you set for yourself. You won't be a quitter. Having won the Heisman Trophy, that gives me a standard to set my goals by. And I will, within all my power, be the very best that I could possibly be in the area that I'm working in.
Perhaps no Heisman winner in recent memory was as flashy as Billy Sims. In 1978, he became only the sixth undergraduate to win the trophy. He then starred with Detroit of the NFL, but a premature injury ended this Lion's career with a whimper and not a bang. On his Texas ranch, Sims recalls what the Heisman meant to him.
Well, winning the Heisman Trophy meant that I was in an elite field, a lot of great athletes. Also, you know, remember that I was a great football player and did add something exciting to the game.
A trio of trophy winners whose lives and careers have taken diverse paths, yet they share the pride in having earned the Heisman honor.
As we've already seen, there are several outstanding college football players in our midst here in the Heisman Room, and Pat Hayden has more.
Well, Jim, Paul Palmer may be the most famous running back from Temple University since Bill Cosby, but his opponents didn't have much to smile about when he went roaring by. Senior Paul Palmer from Potomac, Maryland, led the nation in rushing, and his ball-carrying exploits made him a folk hero of sorts in the city of brotherly love. Temple touted Palmer as larger than life, and in fact, some of his stats did seem superhuman. Take, for instance, his remarkable 170 yards per game rushing average, or his 2,600 all-purpose yards that broke the record Marcus Allen had set in his Heisman Trophy season 5 years ago.
I never thought anybody could gain 300 yards against a defense that I coached, but he, Paul Palmer, did, and I was very much impressed with the way he handled that.
Paul, you've had a sensational career, a great senior year. Who's been the most inspirational person in your life?
I think the biggest inspiration of my life has been my great-grandmother. She's taken care of me since I was about 3 years old. And when I first started, she didn't want me to play football. And as I got older, she encouraged me to keep playing football. And every time I go home, she tells me she loves me and how proud she is of me.
Paul, again, congratulations. Jim?
All right, Pat. You know, 50 years ago, even now, most sports awards are either bowls or cups. But some half century ago, the Downtown Athletic Club wanted to break that mold. So they hired a young sculptor by the name of Frank Alescu to break the mold. Alescu would go on to become a world-famous artist, but the Downtown Athletic Club commissioned him for his first piece. It was the Heisman Trophy. Alescu needed a model, and he turned to his high school buddy, Ed Smith, who at the time was playing football for New York University. He is the first of several players who posed for the trophy. And we're pleased to be joined now by Frank Alescu and Ed Smith. And Mr. Alescu, why a statue 50 years ago?
Well, there's one thing about a statue rather than a bowl or anything like that. There's a sense of recall, emotion. There's something that you can see and feel and relate to.
Did you ever expect this thing would turn out to be such a classic as it has when you were a young man building that thing for the first time?
Well, you know, creating a piece of sculpture is very, very much like giving birth. A piece of art that you do will live with you. It's something that grows and you feel that it's almost a human quality. It's something that you want to be proud of, and I feel that the Heisman Trophy certainly is something that has given me something to really be proud of.
No question about that. Ed Smith, unusually, you found out only 4 years ago that you were the original model for this trophy. How did you find
out? Very true. I got a call one night from a PR man. He says to me, are you Ed Smith? I said, yes. He says, did you know you posed for the Heisman Trophy? I says, not that I remember. He said, let me ask you a question. Do you know Frank Gillespie? I says, I certainly do, and that's why I'm here today.
All right.
One thing I'd like to say to these fellas. Whoever wins this trophy, I want you to know that I feel sorry for you, because you know why? You're going to have to look at my ugly face for a long time.
All right, Mr. Smith. Would you give us that famous pose one more time?
I don't know if my legs can take it.
One last time, the pose.
Let me see how it was done.
All right, we'll continue live from the Downtown Athletic Club in just a moment. As a yardstick of what kind of media event this has become, there are a record 115 reporters and photographers here in the club tonight. But when it comes to good stories and colorful quotes, I'm sure the media would cast its ballot for Oklahoma's linebacker Brian Bosworth.
Brian Bosworth of Irving, Texas is not your ordinary college athlete. You might say he dances to the beat of a different drummer. His tonsorial creativity has distinguished him and earned him comparisons to another nonconformist of note, Bears quarterback Jim McMahon. But the Boz is all business on the field. He anchored the Sooners' top-ranked defense that led the nation in rushing defense, passing defense, and scoring defense, shutting out 5 of 11 opponents.
Brian Bosworth is one of the great defensive football players that we've ever gone against. Now he's a very complete linebacker, big, strong, fast guy, tough guy. He's played extremely well against us. I think he's an excellent, excellent college football player and will be a good pro.
Brian, you are a junior redshirt at Oklahoma. You could make yourself eligible for the NFL draft this spring. What would it take for you to come back to Oklahoma, though?
Well, Jim, you know better than anybody, and if I made a decision now, I think that makes it too easy for both parties involved. No one squirms that way, so I'm gonna let it go as long as I can before I make a decision. And then maybe the Heisman Trophy might make a key factor in it.
All right, out of curiosity, I know you talk quite often with Jim McMahon, the Bears quarterback, on the phone quite often. What do you talk about? I'm just curious.
We talk about making sure that neither one of us back down from our way of speaking. It seems to be not exactly accepted among American society, but there's a few of them out there that accept what we do, and I think a few more of them will turn over to our way of life.
All right, Brian, congratulations on an outstanding season. And right now, let's go back to Pat with a very special guest.
All right, Jim, I think one of the most memorable moments in Heisman Trophy history took place in 1973 when my guest, John Cappelletti, accepted the award dedicated to his brother Joey, who was then dying of leukemia. John, thanks for being with us, first of all, but obviously a very emotional moment.
Yes, it was. It was doubly emotional because at the time there was something very happy to celebrate, and at the same time we were very concerned about Joey's health, and at any time something devastating could have happened. So it was hard to figure out where our emotions lied, but I think at the Heisman dinner that night it all worked itself out very well.
Well, as you know, he passed away 3 years later, but I'm sure he was really lifted by your dedication.
Yeah, that was one thing that I'm sure my mother would tell you a better story than I could, but every time that he would come up to a Penn State game, the anticipation and then the participation in a Penn State football weekend and then in the Heisman Trophy celebration was the best medicine that he ever had.
All right, John, again, thank you very much for being with us. And we're going to go over to Jim Nantz now, who has the story on this year's leading candidate for the Heisman Trophy.
All right, Pat, you know, when we think of Vinny Testaverde, we think of the quick strike touchdown from almost anywhere on the field. But what we don't often consider is his great patience. Like the actor who once said, "I've worked a lifetime to become an overnight success," Testaverde had to wait his turn at Miami, first sitting behind Jim Kelly, then behind Bernie Kosar. But the fruits of his patience, though, are the stuff of which Heismans are made. Vinny Testaverde of Elmont, New York, is the nation's leading passer. He also knows how to pass away leisure time with friends and teammates in a city where the heat is on. Testaverde scorched opponents for 26 touchdown passes. The Hurricanes have won 20 of 22 games he has started, including the big win over Oklahoma. He's won the Walter Camp Award, the Maxwell Trophy, and the school has retired his jersey. And recently, Oklahoma coach Barry Switzer also paid tribute.
Testaverde is the best quarterback that we have ever played against in my 21 years at Oklahoma.
Well, that's quite a compliment coming from Barry Switzer, isn't it, Vinny?
It is quite a compliment coming from a great coach like Coach Switzer.
How about the patience I talked about? How difficult was it for a player of your ability to sit for 3 years?
Well, I sat down in high school, and I had the experience to learn how to sit and wait there, and it's been a humbling experience, and I'm sure everybody knows it's been a dream of mine and my dad's to make this award happen, to win it tonight, and I hope it could come true for both of us.
How many family members are here tonight in attendance?
There's about 20 or 30 around the audience, yeah.
All right, Vinny, congratulations on a great season. Good luck to you, and we'll be back with the 1986 Heisman winner. The announcement coming up next on CBS. ...1,050 media members around the country, and here's how it breaks down. 3 points awarded for a first-place choice, two for a second place, and one for third. The results have been tabulated and maintained by the accounting firm of Deloitte, Haskins, and Sells. You know, there have been many outstanding college performers this season. Two others were invited. Jim Harbaugh of Michigan could not attend, as well as DJ Dozier of Penn State. However, both, again, were among the outstanding performers this year in college football.
Jim Harbaugh of Kalamazoo, Michigan, is the nation's second-ranked passer behind Vinny Testaverde. Last year, he led the country in passing, and this year, he has led the Wolverines into the Rose Bowl.
Jim is an exceptional quarterback, but he's more than that. He's a great youngster and a great leader. And typical of the quarterbacks that we've had here in the past, he wins football games.
D.J. Dozier of Virginia Beach, Virginia, is Penn State's second all-time leading rusher. This year, he has helped the Nittany Lions achieve a perfect regular season record, setting up next month's national championship game against Miami. Brent Fullwood of St. Cloud, Florida, led the nation with over 8 yards per carry. The Southeast Conference leading ground gainer, Fullwood emerged from the shadow of last year's Heisman Trophy winner, Vincent Bo Jackson, to become a star in his own right. Kevin Sweeney of Fresno, California, is the NCAA's all-time passing yardage leader. This 10-yard play broke the old mark held by 1984 Heisman Trophy winner Doug Flutie. Sweeney's coach and father, Jim, and Kevin's teammates were justly proud of this milestone. Gordon Lockbaum of Glassboro, New Jersey, led the nation in scoring with 22 touchdowns. As the first genuine two-way player in major college football in almost two decades, Gordo, only a junior, led Holy Cross to a 10-1 season. And right now, let me introduce the chairman of the Heisman Trophy Committee, Tony Socia. Tony?
Thank you, Jim. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the Heisman electors throughout the country, the Heisman Trophy Committee, and the staff of the Downtown Athletic Club for their outstanding efforts this year. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Tony. And right now, with the official announcement, is the Downtown Athletic Club president, Eugene Meyer.
Thank you, Jim.
Thank you.
It's my privilege on behalf of the Downtown Athletic Club to announce the winner of the Heisman Trophy. Before I do, though, President Reagan has requested that I congratulate the recipient on his behalf and invite him to visit him at the White House. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the 1986 Heisman Trophy winner is, from the University of Miami and Long Island, Vinny Testaverde.
Much. I just want to say, Dad, we dreamed it together, we lived it together, and tonight I could probably say that we won it together. I want to thank my mom and my family for always being there for me when I needed them, my friends, coaches, and teammates. I want to thank Coach Johnson and Coach Stevens for believing in me and bringing out the best of me as a person and as an athlete. Tonight, as I stand here to accept this award, I don't accept it for myself alone. I accept it for all those people that have helped me make my dream come true. Thank you, and God bless you.
And we'll be back to talk with the 1986 Heisman Trophy winner and a look at how the voting broke down in just a moment.
We're back live at the Downtown Athletic Club, where Vinny Testaverde has just won the Heisman Trophy for 1986. I'm not sure who is happier, his father, Al, or Vinny himself, but Vinny, congratulations.
Thank you, Pat. It's just a great honor to be here tonight and to win this award.
Are you relieved? And there's been a lot of pressure on you the last few weeks. Can you kind of exhale now and relax?
Well, when things are going so good and you got great athletes all around you, there really is no pressure.
Well, you've now won the Heisman Trophy. Your team is ranked number one. You'll be playing January 2nd for the national championship against Penn State. Could things be going better?
No, they couldn't. I can't wait to get out and play in the Sunkissed Fiesta Bowl. It's going to be a great game, and I wish I could be out there in the stands watching it myself.
Well, Al, we're going to come to you. I know you're having a tough time here, but you were recorded as saying that you once dreamed of winning this trophy yourself. How do you feel now that your son has won it?
It's a blessing. I thank God. It's real nice. It's a great honor. Thank you.
Vinny, where are you going to keep the trophy?
I don't know. We haven't made a place for it, but I'm sure we'll find somewhere for it.
All right. Again, congratulations. Jim?
All right. Thank you, Pat. And let's take a look at the final standings in the Heisman voting for 1986. Of course, Vinny Testaverde, the winner. Paul Palmer of Temple was second. Jim Harbaugh, the Michigan quarterback, finished third. Brian Bosworth was fourth.
And fifth was Gordy Lockbaum, the junior from Holy Cross. Once again, our congratulations go out to the 1986 Heisman Trophy winner, Vincent Frank Testaverde of the University of Miami by way of Elmont, New York.
Lisa, what position does Uncle Vinny play?
Quarterback.
And what number is he?
14.
And what game does he play?
Football.
He used to go to bed at night with a football underneath his pillow.
He'd always come over the house with a football in his hand. Let's have a catch right in front of the house. Let's play two-hand touch. We get some guys around the neighborhood.
As a youngster, 3-4 years old, he threw the ball exceptionally well.
He could throw the ball. I mean, he could throw the ball at 9 years old, 25 yards on the line.
He used to write his name about 100 times on a piece of paper. And they ask him what for, and he'd say, because when I get famous, I want to have a good signature.
The one moment that everybody will always remember was in Vinny's junior year. We sent him into the ball game to run a double pass. He stands there just like you see him standing there now, just as calm, as cool as he could be, and throws a 45-yard strike for the winning touchdown. That was the moment when you looked at out there at Vinny and you said to yourself, this is a really special kid.
I recruited him coming out of high school, and I knew he was going to be a great one because he did have the strong arm, he had the size. I guess he had a little bit of everything.
I can remember when Vinny's second start, when he lined up behind Dave Elechner, our left guard, instead of the center, and we were all laughing so hard that we couldn't get the playoff.
Last summer, Vinny comes up to me and he says, Father, he said, let's go out to dinner tonight. I'd like to talk to you about something. Puts down his fork and he says, do you think I've got a chance to make professional football? And I about choked on my lasagna.
Every mother should have a boy like him. It's a mother's dream.
I'm very, very proud to have a son like him.
The CBS Sports Special, the Heisman Trophy Award, has been sponsored by Eastman Kodak Company, creators of Kodakolor VRG film, The Color of Life, of Kodak VR35 cameras, the easy way to shoot great 35mm pictures, and makers of new Kodak Super Life batteries. Don't settle for less. Go for the gold. The Heisman Trophy Award has been a presentation of CBS Sports.